Men have the thin in the top and on both sides the back has a ton of hair. How are you gonna adjust it? Very nice haircut for this. Old cutting hair today and the middle-aged men, you know, men, the middle-aged men usually very thin in the top, but still have a lot of thick hair and back and side. That's sometimes a lot of problem there. Side of the head has, you see it, it's a lot of hair towards the back. That's why he can very difficult control. We'll see, look at the left side. Left side, the same thing. She had a very much thick hair and side to the bottom. So again, he don't like to taper, but he like to be control the hair. Look at the front. He had the right-hand side already stick up because he had a very strong colic there. He don't like to be hair stick up, so he after shampoo, towel dry, he have to do a lot of product to press it down there. But he don't want to use the product, he just be dry and natural as possible. That's a certain way to cut hair, we could do that. We'll see how much we could do today. Let's go start cutting hair.
Video, yeah. So he could post on his
Instagram, something like that.
Yeah.
The first one, because he had so much hair there, but we don't want to tapering here, just cutting for the bulk off. Take this much off, like from here to this, to the straight down. Oh, Andre, take the my, go back a little bit, take the, my body position there, here. Just hold it. That could you take a little further back? All right. Take the, my body position. This one, that's a very important there.
What's connection haircut and the body position? Because when you stand still, move the hand. Either way you do it, almost impossible to make a straight movement. All hand is a make a circular motion. You don't understand this mechanic, it's a very difficult cut hair good. How to bring the left hand right front of you? It's a very simple, stand up parallel, put left foot forward, 1 foot forward, and then hand automatically come to front of the face. That's so simple. Now you understand, but you have to be the habit to do it, you have to have a training. Now standing, left foot forward, right way to stand up, and the right way to hold the hand. But if you don't move the body, you just use the hand to bring it in there. Again, circular motion, you're cutting a 45 degree angle. If you try to do the vertical cut, that's a very difficult way to do it. Now I have to show you how to training in a vertical pull of the hair straight out. First place the 2 o'clock position, then move the forward to the body, then that catch up your hair from the scalp, then pull straight out. That sound looks easy, but you gotta do a training them. This is the sideways of the pulling hair. Just look at it and head to the forward, then bring back again. So this is the same way you're doing, just sit for the sideways to look at it, how they work. I like to show you how they work the footwork. This is I show you the foot movement. As you see them the forward, back the legs go up and come back, and the frontal legs a little up. So, but this is the very important, and but if you push too hard, you can't do it. To make it remain stay straight, the movement. Now, opposite the way to show the picture movement, you see that my shoulder and arm to stay there straight. Then that's why you could bring back straight backward. So if you bring the straight backward or position, the hair cutting position, now you could cut a vertical very clearly. Now we look at it through the back side of view of the same movement. As you see it, my shoulder is really in aiming for the cutting position in the left shoulder. So that position have to be very clear, have to be done.
So you gotta be too sideways. I can't. You have the vertical, you have to be very into this one. So that against the cutting position to do it. Right? They cut them off. So we don't taper yet. You just take a bulk off first. Then bring it here towards the center. You don't want to cut off that too much in that corner. Just leave it there. Stay same place. Oops. Andre, take the 4 foot I move right now here. Foot.
Start cutting in the back of the head vertical. I standing in 2 o'clock position. And then cutting towards the neckline. I bring the hair towards the center. But still same, remain stay at 2 o'clock position until finish. When finish the haircut and the neckline, I have to move the 12 o'clock foot, the left foot, to the sideway to move it, to bring in all front of the hair to behind the ear to cut it. But right foot remains stay the same place.
Foot, the next section, I move the half, 1 foot here, then change the position of the body position, then stay the, everything towards center there. Make sure you don't cut it too much. Yeah. If you bring in here, that's enough here, this side, it's done. Okay, Andre? Mm-hmm. So it's gonna be this side, the front, to bring it in.
Now you move to the right 45 degree front of the chair, at 10 o'clock position, left foot to 10, right foot to 12 o'clock position to stand.
Yeah, many people don't need this part here. I'm just standing here, bringing here, whole thing. Then if you do that, just put back here, say automatically tapering here. So then hold it here, just straight up, make sure to come this way. Sideways, just keep cutting there, stay there same. You don't want to cut too much off, stay away from the certain spot. Just bring the all hair to that section, yeah, this section. Take excess cutting off.
Are you paying for this? Right. Because I pay him $10 an hour for that.
$10 an hour. Do I get residuals?
Right.
You better give him the tip that client's going to give you.
Okay, here you go. Down. Then here, we're going to be cutting off a little more shoulder. You want to be a little bit, you want to clean up here?
You can clean up there. Are you teaching him? Is that what this is? Huh?
This is for him teaching his other people that he teaches. Yeah.
He clean up here a little bit. Then here, this is the key there. Bring down here. Bring the whole thing in against this spot.
If my client comes and he's not up there to check my client in, we're going to have a problem. I'm going to hold it, even though I have... I'm a very nervous individual right now. No, I'm just kidding. I'm gonna hold it for him, okay?
Huh?
I'm doing it.
How's he doing?
He's doing okay. I mean, he's no Paula, but he's doing okay. I'm just kidding. I'm Paula. That's what I'm doing. No, he's doing great.
Paula, cut it here, this part. Yeah, just bring it here. Everything stop right on here.
Yeah.
Okay. So that never be shown the skin that this way, all the way down like
no,
that.
I don't like. Oh, see, my client's here now.
Okay, that's enough.
After I cut him off the all hair in the back, this is the finished look. I told you he don't want to taper, so I'll get the very tapering in the bottom and as natural as possible. That's why I finished the back of the head. If you go back a little bit, you see that for the top of the back of the head, he has a very thin. So we have to take all bulk out the back of the head. That's what we have to do it. Now look at the left side to the look at the back. You see the left side, top of the ear and the front. I took tremendous amount of the hair to take off to make sure smooth down and also to not too much bulky looking. That's what we did. How about right side? This is the same thing, but you see the right side, the back of the head, more thin section, and that front is a really thickness still there. And that's what I had one when I finished this one. I got a little problem there when I finished it. Later, I didn't put on anything in a men's haircut. I just dry the scalp, then just comb through. As you see, when I did that, and the top of the cardiac area and the left side, right hand side, really pop up. Now I'm gonna do this one. Then I find out around for the top of the front of the top of the head, and between the back of the head had a lot of thick hair left over there. I have to do something about this section. What I did is this section, I do the inside out haircut and I reduce it a lot of bulk of it. Inside out haircut meaning internal make different layer in the hair and not much cutting the lengths off, and then control it much more smoothly done. So I will show you what it's supposed to do this kind of haircut. Inside out haircut I call, take the internals out, the internal hair would make it all different layer. So that way we could control it and a small hair and a long hair to control easier. That's what we use this time stroke cut technique to do it. After inside out haircut, top with or without inside out haircut, bottom with or without inside out haircut. As you see that we reduce a lot of bulkiness out. Now he could control the very easy to do it. Finally, I just said I did inside out the haircut. Inside out haircut use it thin scissors or stroke cut between the root to the middle shaft, take not necessary hair to take off. But do not cut the lengths off. If your lengths off, then it will be a little problem. So as you see it, and after when it's done, comb through. If your scalp dry, hair's automatic dry. Just use the comb to comb through with it. All hair place it very nicely. Thank you for watching the video a long time. If you have any comment, anything, please write it down for me. I appreciate it. Thank you.